Welcome to this full issue of MMTV News Magazine. Welcome to this week's edition of MMTV News Magazine. I'm Tammy Bennett, and I'm joined by Jamie and Mariah Berryhill, and we are broadcasting from WOW Warehouse in Odessa, Texas.
This week's encouraging stories include the Oilfield Christian Fellowship Luncheon,
the Back to School Bash, sponsored by the First United Pentecostal Church of Midland,
the Baptist Men's Disaster Relief,
the Mission Messiah Thursday Luncheon,
and something you'll be sure to love, the Olympic Moments of Faith. You will get to see Mission Messiah's very own Haley McBride on Faces of Faith. On Perspective, Esme Pine and I will be sharing our thoughts on intentional relationships.
Dean Jarrett, good to meet you, Roy.
The Oilfield Christian Fellowship Luncheon is held at the Rock the Desert Warehouse. The purpose is to allow people in the oil field to come together with like-minded believers and support each other during both good and bad times.
One of my favorite verses in the Bible, it just makes me light up whenever I think about it, Romans 5:8. But God demonstrates his own love toward us, and while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
We want to know that there's brothers and sisters in Christ. They're right there where they are. A lot of times they're out on a rig or on location and they feel like they're the only one out there that's really standing up and living for God. And so we want them to know that there's other brothers and sisters in Christ. We want them to know that God loves them, that the Word of God is gonna help them know that they are cared for. A lot of these guys have lost their jobs. They've found jobs, and some of them are in the process of losing their jobs. Psalms tells us that it says, I've been young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor their children begging bread. God has promises to us, and we want them to know that God loves them and will provide for them.
The next luncheon will be held September 16th and then again in October during the oil show. They invite oil field personnel to join them and enjoy food and the gospel of Christ.
You are washed, but you are sanctified, but you are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of God.
Are you excited for school?
Today we're hosting a back to school bash. We are so excited to be here, and as you look, the skies have cleared. We was expecting rain today, and the canopy has erased on the beautiful landscape of God's creation.
Highlighter?
And a pen?
And a pen?
And a pen?
Are you ready for school? Are you excited?
Yay!
On a level, just by myself, I'm not really able to give, but with the team of my brothers and sisters that are here, all of us pulled together are able to give a lot more than what I would be able to individually. So there, it's uplifting my spirit just to see all the kids that are coming and the parents that are coming, and they're saying thank you. They're not just grabbing and walking off, and that right there is just reward enough just for the little kids to say, oh, I want that, I want a pink, I want that, and just to see the smile on their face and know that they won't have to go to school on Monday morning without any school supplies.
Awesome.
The heart and the soul of this is people. We understand that in our culture we worship in buildings. Jesus was never corralled in a building. His ministry was in the community, touching people, and everywhere he went, people were attracted to him. I believe it's because of the unconditional love that he had for humanity. He didn't judge them. He always spoke truth, but it was always preceded by grace. And so our endeavor here today is to get outside of our building, to let our community know that we love them and we're reaching out to them and we want to be a blessing to them. It's all about the souls, and that's what we're about. We're out here to touch people, and in touching people, we hope that they can feel the love of Christ. Our motto at our church is very simple. We'll love you in so many ways you're bound to like some of them.
The recent floods in Louisiana have the Permian Basin unit of the Baptist Disaster Relief Team set on high alert. The trucks are packed with food, and the shower truck is prepared to move out at the first call.
When we stage, we make sure that all the equipment that's going to be needed to cook the meals when we get down there is on the trailer, it's working, and it's ready to go. We also have to make sure that the truck and the trailer are in a condition to make a trip that far, like making sure the tires are aired up on the trailer, trucks fueled up, oiled up, and ready to go.
As a connection source for encouraging stories, we would love to hear your stories.
Please send those stories to mediateam@gmail.com.
Mission Messiah is an 18-month program for women and women with children.
Those real-life experiences are what should make truth easily entreated.
Our desire is to see women set free from life-debilitating substances and events. Our program is solidly based on Jesus Christ and His plan of living. Our emphasis on biblical study, scripture memorization, life skill development, and renewed family living is interconnected to bring wholeness back to hopeless lives.
And the Son and the Holy Spirit.
WOW Warehouse and Zip Business Services developed out of the need for practical job training and discipleship. They are flourishing businesses filled with our graduates and trainees. Is Mission Messiah the answer for someone you know?
Joining us today for Faces of Faith, we have Haley McBride. She is a recent graduate of Mission Messiah and someone I have gotten to know very well.
And I hope you'll be encouraged by my story. I knew I needed help because that's scary and I thought I was going crazy. Surrender who I thought I was. Surrender any rights that I thought I had or opinions that I thought were factual. I needed a savior. I needed something or someone, and it took me to realize that for me to surrender. The fact that I had reached a point to where I was thinking of homicide and suicide, I knew I needed help because that's scary. And I thought I was going crazy. I never knew that Satan could put thoughts into your head. I was just scared. And that's what drove me to get help was fear. I was fearful of what I was going to do, whether to myself or someone else. I had to turn to God. He was my last hope. I was so excited to come to Mission Messiah. I just had this peace about it. However, I still had it made up in my mind that if God didn't show up in my life, then I was just going to off myself. Looking back now, I can see that He was there with me throughout many different difficult times in my life. However, the first time I really experienced him without really knowing him, I almost got into a car wreck. And I literally felt the tail end of my car move out of the way. And I just knew that I knew that I knew that that was just supernaturally impossible. Like, it was impossible for that to happen. And that.
So would you call that God, or would you call that intervention?
Ultimately, God. But how I would describe it now is divine redirection. And He's faithful even when we're not. So I do believe that He shows up and shows out for even those who haven't accepted Jesus as Lord. I do believe that. And the moment you realize that he's real and that he wants nothing but the best for you, and even if it takes those romantic, you know, divine redirection moments, he'll get there. You'll get there. But you also have to be willing to receive it, because it's already there. You just have to receive it. Dear younger me.
Can I ask you a really silly question? Do you like to shop? Well, how would you like to shop for beautiful gifts, for a beautiful purpose, for beautifully changed lives? That is what WOW is all about. WOW not only stands for Women of Worth, it stands for Totally WOW Shopping. WOW is one of Mission Messiah's work training stores. Women of Mission Messiah learn to support themselves and their babies. We pray and believe that you are about to engage in a shopping experience and shopping relationship like never before. WOW is always on the move with fresh WOW. Visit often and enjoy. Just bookmark wowwarehouse.org.
Come one, come all, to Mission Messiah to enjoy our community Thursday lunch at 1213 West 2nd, Odessa. We start at 11:30, and it's a come-and-go event. The fantastic food is cooked by volunteers and the women of Mission Messiah. The reason we have chosen to open our doors is to embrace the community and share the love of the Lord.
Let's just stand up and circle hands kind of around the room as we are.
Come and see us on Thursdays.
And it's a joy to watch other people enjoy food together. I think eating together is very important. It's biblical. It's bonding. Just creates an atmosphere of having a good time and loving one another.
Oh, yeah. There you go. That is medal worthy.
The name of Jesus has been lifted up during the 2016 Rio Summer Olympics. The beauty of these next moments is to encourage us by seeing the world's best athletes celebrate, by giving glory to the Creator of the universe, and to recognize their special athletic talents.
Steele Johnson, you are going to the Olympics. We see the emotion. Describe what's going through your mind.
I've been working for this dream for a long time, and it's honestly, I never thought like the day would come, and I feel like I just blinked. Now I'm on the 2016 Olympic team, but it's cool because this is exciting, this is fun, but like this is not where my identity is going to be in the rest of my life. Yeah, I'm Steele Johnson, the Olympian, but at the same time, I'm here to love and serve Christ. My identity is rooted in Christ and not in the flips we're doing, but it's all here, and it's... I wasn't ready for it.
And there's the gun. Bartoletta got away well. Now Tori Bowie coming on. And English Gardner as they come to the line. Bartoletta, Bowie, and Gardner. I think Gardner,
I think Gardner got it. I think Gardner got it. 10.74. The wind is legal. So with a new personal best, the Oregon Duck, English Gardner, pulls the upset, handing Bowie her first loss of the year. Bartoletta in second. Bowie has to settle for third. And look at how fast those times are.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, I praise you. Thank you so much, God. Thank you, Jesus.
And that's the emotion, Tom, of somebody who was here 4 years ago and did not see the Olympic team. She comes back and finds a way to not only get on the team, but to win in a new personal best. That's one of the fastest times ever run. 10.74 for the Oregon Duck, English Gardner.
Well, congratulations. A gold medal, a world record. Are you still pinching yourself?
Yeah, I'm really just grateful for what happened last night.
I left it all in God's hands, and He's produced. And I'm so thankful for Him choosing me last night to live out my talents and my blessings. And yeah, it was an amazing experience. And yeah, I'm so, so grateful for what happened last night. And I got over the finish line, and I think the first thing I could say is thank you, God. Thank you, God. That's the only thing that repeatedly came to mind.
You came in here as a huge favorite. How did you live up to that for gold?
Man, I just kept God first and just continued to let Him guide me throughout the rounds. And we formed a prayer circle this morning, and we just let His presence come upon us and just help us come out here and continue to glorify Him and do the best that we can. And that's what we did.
Well, Nia, you have little Titus Maximus with you now, but your mom had him in the stands. How did you stay focused for 10 hurdles to grab the silver?
I mean, I knew it was going to take just a lot of just discipline, and I knew it was going to be very hard to even just medal because everyone was going out there with the same goals in mind. I'm just happy that me and these ladies were able to pull it off because we prayed hard about this and we didn't let the distractions get to us, so it was great.
Intentional relationships will be the focus on Perspective today. I'm Rye Berryhill with MMTV News Magazine, and here with me again this week, I have Esme Payan.
It's great to be back with you.
This week, we wanted to go over something we had mentioned in the previous episode. That was how important relationships can be and what a role they play in your life. How would you say you had some good ones and bad ones throughout high school?
Some friendships definitely were 70-30. It was me giving 70 and receiving 30, and that's not the kind of friendship you want, and it makes you feel really bad. It makes you not feel special. And I definitely had good ones, and it was like 50-50. It's very important to have those good relationships and friendships because you want to rely on someone. That's what friends are for. You want to have someone to lean on you, give and take kind of friendship.
I totally agree on that. I had, you know, the good and the bad, of course. I think we all do, but something the scripture is very clear about is just we're called to love everyone and love how He loves us. And that's so unconditional no matter what people put us through and stuff. So one thing we wanted to encourage y'all in is just being intentional and genuine. And that's the thing. Next thing I'm going to ask her is like, how would you now looking back have made those 70-30 friendships a little bit more intentional?
I think with our generation, the phone is such a big deal, and you'll be sitting there with your friend and you just want to come, like sometimes I had a bad day and I just want to text my friend like, hey, can I talk to you? But then you meet up with them and they're just on their phones the whole time, and that's such an awful feeling to feel like you're boring someone or you're not important enough to be listened to. So I think the phone was definitely a big deal because I know I did that a lot. Sometimes I just, you know, pick up my phone while my friend's talking to me, and it's like whenever I would receive it in return, it would just make me feel awful. So if I could go back, that's something I would fix, and that's something I'm currently working on, definitely putting my phone down, spending time with people who are there actual in real time, and just listening.
I completely agree. I've been there. I've been the friend on my phone, and I've also been the person on the flip side trying to share my heart and share where I'm at and what happened to me. And they're so distracted, and that hurts so bad, and to the point where I would just, you know what, forget it. Like, I'm good, you know? And then they're like, oh, I'm so sorry, what were you saying? And you're just like, I've repeated myself three times. Like, and that just makes it miserable on both fronts, really. And just, so that's our encouragement, y'all. Don't be that person. Social media can be such a positive thing, but in these relationships that we were talking through that are gonna make life worthwhile, put the phone down. It's not worth it. It can wait. So that's our heart. We hope y'all hear that. Thank y'all so much for watching. I'm Rye Berryhill.
And I'm Esme Fayan.
Have a great week.
It's just a low profile plate carrier. Inside of this is hardened steel. What that will do is it will stop high caliber rifles like the 5.56 or 223, which is what the AR-15 uses.
Well, one morning I was preparing to get to go to work, and I was watching the 700 Club, and they were talking about the officers that had been recently killed in Dallas.
And residents of Dallas are in shock after a devastating night of violence there. At least five police officers are dead and others critically injured after shooters disrupted a peaceful protest with a stunning assault.
And I thought, well, what better way to protect our officers but to provide a vest? And so my heart was convicted to possibly make a donation to help buy a vest for an officer. And I came to the pharmacy that morning and I talked to our manager, Jenna. And I asked her, I said, what do you think about doing like a little raffle, like we did once before, raffle off something and try to raise enough money to buy a vest? And she ran with that. And then all of a sudden, a week later, we had this massive event planned with food trucks and the blood services, and it just kind of exploded. It was a God thing. I was anticipating maybe buying one vest. And now we've raised money last tally, last week, to buy up to 30 vests.
The ones we're looking at, which is amazing, these will run anywhere between $400 and $600 a piece, depending on the kind of carrier we get, the kind of plates we get, and the equipment to go on. So what's great about them, too, there's two kinds. There's steel and there's ceramic or composite. The ones we've tested right now are steel. And what's so great about them is they're less expensive than ceramic, and they got a 20-year shelf life. That's only a few cents a day over a career. And with the way the world is now, we're seeing active shooters every month, every week now. This is what we're trying to get because it's necessary these days. Like I say, if we can't get to the people that need help, then there's nothing we can do. So we'll go forward. We'll always keep moving forward to help people. But we want to make sure that we can get to y'all, and these will help us get to y'all. So.
Well, it's just been amazing, the community, how they've come together, and just everybody has just been so generous.
This is amazing. I mean, we've had people just come up to us when we're eating and say thank you. They want to pay for our meals. Sometimes they won't even let us. It's amazing.
We just have to say, hey, we want to buy a vest for our police officers, and they've opened up their wallets, and it's just been an amazing blessing. We hope that this will like plant a seed in other people's minds.
MMTV News traveled to Andrews, Texas to meet up with Greg Griffin, a man intent on bringing change to his small Texas town.
Andrews, Texas was in the top 10 of the nation of teen suicide and teen pregnancies. So that's one of the things that God laid on my heart. We had kids sleeping in the park. I grew up in Andrews and we didn't have those issues when I was a kid. We want to give something positive. So we have to go to them and reach out and get them where we can get a hold of them and give them the word.
The whole reason this all came together was a report came out that Andrews was among the top 10 in the nation of teen suicide, teen pregnancy, and teen drug addiction. Greg Griffin of GTG Automation, Plumbing, Electrical, Heating, and Air, he decided to do something about it. And he literally had an encounter with God. He was obedient. He brought the Newsboys here, Switchfoot, Mercy Me, Casting Crowns, For King and Country, the biggest names in the Christian music industry, right here to Andrews. The restaurants packed out, 7-Eleven sold out of gas. History was made, and people like Greg Griffin, people like Rio Brownlee, people like Rick Doyle of B1 Ministries. We're just watching people come together, the city come together in prayer, coming together in effort to initially reach the youth, but now people of all ages are being reached and brought together under one banner, which is the kingdom of God, which is Jesus Christ.
We've had 50-something different bands since that point in time. We've had Mercy Me.
You're beautiful.
We've had Newsboys.
We believe in God the Father.
And then we've had some of the smaller groups, Rapture, Ruckus.
One, two, three, let's go!
We like them all. The small bands seem to be more intimate with the kids and really get involved with them. And so certainly, you know, we like that. support the Blue. I know that they don't make a whole lot of money and for what they do. And I just wanted to support, show support that, that we're behind them, that, that we do appreciate what they do, that Blue lives do matter, that they've got a hard road. Every time they answer a call, they don't know what they're going towards. And I just want to make sure that they've got the money to fix their ACs when they get home and they can have a cool night.
This week on Dunamis, Jamie, you are going to be our power hitter. Can you remind us what Dunamis means?
Dunamis, much like it sounds itself, is a root of dynamic, dynamite. And so it essentially means power, excessive power, explosive power, dynamic.
So what are you going to be teaching us about?
Jesus said that except a man be born again, he would not enter into the kingdom. So we're going to look today at what it means to be dead or alive.
And you're going to give us some great practical examples.
I just wanted to kind of give you a picture today as to what we're talking about. So I brought this, actually I picked this stick up off the ground a minute ago, but this stick is clearly dead. The reality is, this stick is dead because it has been separated from its source of life. Now, on the other hand, if you look at these beautiful green leaves, you see life. You see vibrant life. And the reason these leaves have vibrant life is because they're obviously connected to their source, of life. So what we endeavor to do through Dead or Alive is to see an individual that has been living life spiritually dead be made new through reconnecting to their life source, the God of all creation. We hope that you were encouraged by this week's episode of MMTV. There are so many wonderful stories, so many wonderful things that Jesus is doing through His body throughout the Permian Basin, and we just love sharing them with you.
Mission Messiah Television is a part of Mission Messiah, a residential program for our women and children. Would you prayerfully consider helping us through prayer or even financial support? You can reach us through our website at www.missionmessiah.org. There's a button on the second row of that website that says donate, and we would so appreciate your help.
Also, I just want to share, if you like golf, the annual Mission Cup is coming up. You can call for information on that at 432-580-5222.
And most importantly, Jamie, we want to ask you, do you know a person, a woman, a family in need?